A manufactured component has its quality graded on its performance, appearance, and cost. Each of these three characteristics is graded as either pass or fail. There's a probability of 0.40 that a component passes on both appearance and cost. There's a probability of 0.31 that a component passes on all three characteristics. There's a probability of 0.64 that a component passes on performance. There's a probability of 0.19 that a component fails on all three characteristics. There's a probability of 0.06 that a component passes on appearance but fails on both performance and cost. And the first part asks us, what is the probability that a component passes on cost but fails on both performance and appearance? So basically, what we're going to need is a Venn diagram consisting of three circles. So namely, we're going to have to draw three circles. Okay, three circles. Something like this. It's not going to be exact three circles, but that will do. Okay, so here we're going to have to label the numbers that we know. So if we let the first circle be A, and A is basically referring to appearance. Okay, so the circle will be appearance. Okay, the probability basically for the probability circle for the appearance. All right, so now the B, sorry, not the B, the C in this case, is going to be the circle for cost, the second quality assessment parameter. Now the third circle, finally, will be the performance, so we can label as P, the P circle. So now let's see what we know so far. We know that first probability is given 0.40. It says that the component passes on both appearance and cost. So passes means that basically all of these circles, they're talking about passing. They're talking about individual probabilities of passing based on a given parameter, right? The first circle was A, the second one was C, the cost, and the third one was performance, right? So we have to find now the probability of passing both the appearance and the cost, right? So that means if we're talking about the probability of something shared, right? Because appearance and cost, and is the keyword here, and cost is very important, right? So we're talking about intersection, right? So the intersection of the circles A and C. Okay, so notice that this corresponds to the intersection of A and C, right? This part right here. Okay, and that is equal to 0.4. Now let's see what else do we know. Let's actually find the easier one first. There's a probability of 0.31 that a component passes on all three characteristics. So all three is the intersection of all three parameters, all three circles, which is here. Right, so we can label it immediately as 0.31. Okay, so this spot is 0.31 probability. So now, if we know the 0.31, and we knew that this whole thing, this whole intersection of circles A and C was 0.40, then we know that this is equal to the difference of 0.31 and 0.40, right? Because this whole thing was 0.40, this is 0.31, right? So this must be exactly 0.09. Right, you're subtracting 0.31 from 0.40, you get this 0.09. Okay, so now that we found 0.09, let's keep going and try to fill out more stuff. There's a probability of 0.64 that a component passes on performance, right? So this whole circle probability is 0.64, right? But we don't know these parts, right? We know that 0.31 is obviously part of the whole 0.64, right? Because 0.31 lies exactly inside the circle P, right? But we can't label 0.64 yet, so we're going to have to go on. There's a probability of 0.19 that a component fails on all three characteristics, Right? Failing means that it's not going to be anywhere within these three circles. It's going to be outside. So what we can do, we can make, let's say, an outside rectangle or region, however you want to call it, that will basically contain these circles, right? But we're going to place, we're going to put 0.19 outside these circles, right? So 0.19 is everything in this rectangle but outside these three circles, right? So 0.19, this is the outside probability. Okay, let's keep going. There's a probability of 0.06 that a component passes on appearance but fails on both performance and cost, right? So what they're saying is it's in the circle but it doesn't include the C circle and the P circle regions. So that means it's just going to be this part here, this blank part, right? So that's 0.06. So now the trick here is to somehow solve for some of these regions, right? So now to do that, let's actually talk about what's being asked. So the part A wants us to find the probability that a component passes on cost but fails on both performance and appearance. So they're saying find the probability that you're going to be inside the C circle but at the same time you're going to be outside of the P and A, right? So not P and A but C. So that means we have to find this region here, right? So we can label it as A. Right, we're going to label this as A region. That's what we need to find. Okay, but in order to find this, this is actually going to be tricky. We're going to need, in order to find A, we're going to need these unknown regions as well. So we know that the whole circle P is equal to 0.64. Right, that's the probability of the whole circle P. So we're going to use 0.31, but we have to label this these unknown parts. So let's label them as X, Y and Z, right? So now what we're gonna do, we know that the sum of these four regions is equal to 0.64, the whole probability of the circle P, right? So we can label as, we can write an equation, X plus Y plus Z plus 0.31 is equal to 0.64. So, right, because the individual components of the circle when added make up a full circle, which is given as 0.64. So now we can solve for X, Y, and Z by subtracting 0.31 on both sides. So we're going to get X plus Y plus Z is equal to 0.33, right, if you do the algebra right. So now we know that the sum of X, Y, and Z is equal to 0.33. Now there's one more thing to consider. One thing to consider is that since we know 0.19 as being outside of all these circles, we can find the total probability of all three circles. But not collapsed together, of course, but the total probability of all these regions, right? So we're going to find the probability of these three numbers being the total probability as the sum of these three numbers and the sum of X, Z, Y, and A, right? So all regions together, we're going to find the probability. And we know that because the entire probability is 1, right? So we can say that the probability of A union C union P, right? Union meaning that not separately all circles added together, but every single part that you see here added only once, right? Not overcounting, but added only once. That's going to be equal to 1 minus, right? Because the entire probability is 1. Every single region, including the outside, is equal to 1. 1 minus 0.19. 0.19. Right? Because we're subtracting the outside in order to yield us every single region here added only once, right? So that's going to be 0.81. So now how are we going to use 0.81 and 0.33 here, the equation that we found? Notice that X plus Y plus Z plus A is going to be basically 0.81 minus these numbers that we have. So basically what I'm saying is x plus y plus z plus a. And by the way, notice that a is exactly what we're looking for part a in this question. What is the probability that a component passes on cost but fails on both performance and appearance? Right, so a is being asked here, this region, so we're going to solve for this red a. So what I'm saying is this is going to be set to 0.81, subtracting from 0.81 these three numbers, right? Because we know that if you add everything only once here, all of these regions once, not repeating anything, you will get 0.81, as we've noted before, right? The union of all these circles, right? So if you subtract from the union the x, z, y, and a, you will get these three numbers. The sum of these three numbers. If you subtract the sum of these three numbers from the 0.81, you're going to get the sum of x, z, y, and a. Right? So that's exactly what we're doing. So 0.06 plus 0.09 plus 0.31. Okay? So now we can basically solve for a, and you know why? Because we know x plus y plus z was equal to 0.33, right? So a plus 0.33, because that was the sum that in the equation that we derived before, is equal to 0.81 minus 0.46, right? Because this sum of these three numbers is 0.46. So now a, as a result, if you subtract 0.33 on both sides, is going to be equal to precisely 0.02, right? Because here this will yield you 0.35 minus 0.33 here, when you subtract, is going to be 0.02. So that's the answer to part A. You just found this. Now part B asks us, if a component passes on both appearance and cost, what is the probability that it passes on all three characteristics? So this is obviously the conditional probability. What it's asking you is to do this, the probability of having A union C union P given A union C, right? Because it says if a component passes on both appearance and cost, so that means that's going to be the conditional, that's the given. Given that A and C, right, given the intersection of circles A and C, what is the probability of having all three, the intersection of all three circles, right? So basically what it says is, looking at this region here, the shared region between circles A and C, what is the probability of having the intersection of all three circles, right? And that's fairly easy, right? We know even from the conditional probability notation that we need to have the intersection of these two, and the intersection of these two is exactly this, right? That's going to be exactly A and C and P, right? That's going to be the intersection. And that will be divided by the conditional, the probability of A and C. So as you know, this was given before, right? And you can even find it from the Venn diagram. What is the shared region? The shared region of all three circles is 0.31. And what was the shared region of A and C? That was equal to 0.40, right? If you forgot to read it in the problem, you can sum it up here. Right? There are two ways of getting it, either from your work or from the given. So 0.40. So as you know, if you do this in your calculator, you should get this answer, 0.775. Okay, so this is the answer. So I hope this was useful and fun. Thanks for watching. See you in the next videos.